Everybody, Dave Giltner with Turning Science. I help scientists and engineers design and build rewarding careers in industry. So today I want to talk about a question I get a lot when I speak at universities. Say, Dave, so many employers want industry experience. I've only been in academia. I've been a graduate student. How on earth do I ever get a job? Well, I understand this can be a frustrating concern. Turns out it's not quite the barrier you may think it is. An important thing to keep in mind is everybody who's working in industry at one time had no experience. So it's really not the barrier that it may seem. You can overcome it. So it helps to realize two different things that may not be very clear. First of all, what a company asks for and what a company needs are two different things. Second, a job description is usually not the absolute set of requirements for a job that it may seem. It's actually just the hiring manager's best attempt at thinking about the problems they are facing right now and trying to condense that into some paragraphs or some bullet points that describe the human being they think could come in and solve those problems. But they often don't really know exactly what they need in that person, and that's particularly true if they're looking for somebody with an advanced degree. Also, of course, human beings are not bullet points. Look, the chances of somebody showing up and fitting their description perfectly really are not as high as you might think. And most hiring managers really are not as good at writing job descriptions as you might think. They may be great managers, but trying to turn the work that their team is not currently getting done into a description of the human being who can do it best really is not an easy task. And many of them know that. They don't really think their job descriptions are perfect, and many of them are not expecting an exact match. What they need is somebody who can come in and solve their problems. So, you don't have industry experience, and you can't change that. But that doesn't mean you can't solve their problems. So what you need to do is convince them you can. Now, if you're thinking, well, when I submit my application online, there's going to be an HR screener, and they're going to look at my resume and their checklist, and I won't have the experience they're looking for, and that's where I lose out. If you're thinking that, yes, you're right. If you're relying on submitting applications online, your lack of experience is going to continue to be a problem. But as I always tell people, submitting your application online, relying on online resume submission, is a bad way to find a good job. In fact, I tell people it's like playing the lottery. Sure, somebody's going to win, somebody's going to get that job, but it probably won't be you. Don't play a game you can't win. Submitting online applications is playing a game where somebody else is in complete control, somebody you don't know and can't influence. If you want to build a rewarding career, you have to have some control. Learn to play a game you can win. Find companies you want to work for and make contact with people who work inside those companies. Convince them that you are the right person for the job, that you can solve their problems. That's always the best way to get a job. That's a game you can win. So let's reframe this. What might they really be saying? When they say they want industry experience, most of the time what they're thinking is something along the lines of, if we hire an academic, they may think and work like an academic. They may be interested in working for years on some esoteric problem, working forever until they understand every little detail, rather than working quickly to solve the problems and get results that our customers need right now. This is a common perspective in industry, and frankly, there's some basis in reality. What you have to do is get beyond that academic stereotype. So academia and industry are very different, and if you want to be successful, you need to learn how they're different and adapt the way you think and work. Now, if you want to learn more about this, check out the other videos that are on this channel, or you can check out my blog at turningscience.com. Your job is to convince them that even though you only have experience in academia, you can solve their problems and you can quickly adapt to the industry mindset. But of course, you can only do this if you connect with people in person, not from submitting resumes online. So if you want to take control of this game, I'll give you three important steps. First, research the companies you want to work for. Figure out who works there, what products they're developing, what challenges they might have in developing those products, because that's where you can help. That's where you will find a job. Number two, find ways to connect with the people who work at these companies. You have to be creative, but there's all kinds of different ways. It could be at conferences, it could be through LinkedIn, it could be local meetings. In fact, I have a video, and I'll put the link right there, that will give you some other ideas on this. Number three, tell great stories about your accomplishments that show you are a practical problem solver who can get fast and efficient results. Be creative and find ways to tell stories that convince them you are not the stereotypical academic they might be expecting. Now, how you go about crafting these stories is a much bigger topic that I don't have time for here. But if you go to my website, turningscience.com, scroll to the bottom of the front page, you'll find a link where you can get my guide to telling better stories. It's completely free, and it'll give you a great head start. Well, I hope this has been helpful. Just remember, all of us who are out in industry now got our first jobs without any industry experience. You can do it too. Just follow the three steps in this video, and you'll get around this roadblock. Now, if you like this video, please click that subscribe button so you can be the first one to see the next one. I post about 2 short videos a month to help you make progress in your career without taking too much of your time. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.